What is going on, YouTube land? I am Chris Catalunya. Right now, I'm sporting that Sokka from Avatar The Last Airbender, sporting that haircut right now. I got some cowlicks right here. Anyways, before we get into the shoe review today, go and check out my Instagram, Chris Catalunya, with the underscore at the end. Go ahead and like, subscribe, and hit that notification bell so you know when to upload a new video. And guys, we finally hit that 10,000 subscriber mark on this channel. I am gratefully appreciative of your support to the channel. Thank you. So we actually raffled off that Super Soaker already, who went to Dreas Logic, and then the Floral Skateboard deck that went to Kevin Posadas. Definitely, I'm gonna host another raffle probably when we hit that 25,000 mark on this channel. So yeah, just stay tuned. So today we are going to be talking about that recent release from Nike, the Nike Presto in the Red Orbit colorway. But before we get into the specifics of the shoe, let's talk a little history about the Nike Presto. Now, the Nike Presto was a shoe that was created in the year 1999-2000. It was introduced at the Sydney Olympics in the year 2000. And the reason why the Nike team came up with the shoe is because they wanted to create a shoe that closely mimicked barefoot running. And it's pretty cool to know that the Nike Presto paved the way for the Nike Freeze. Now, coming full circle, these shoes were supposed to be released during the Tokyo 2020 Summer Olympic Games. So this is the 20th anniversary for the Air Presto. Again, the naming of this Nike Presto colorway is the Red Orbit. I don't know anyone that has the shoe in hand or tried to get the shoe in hand that's actually calling them the Red Orbits. Most people are calling them the Korea Prestos or the South Korea Prestos. These Prestos were created with the South Korean football or soccer team in mind, as they did qualify for the Tokyo 2020 Summer Olympics. The South Korean football team employs or has a mascot of a white tiger, so it's only fitting to design a shoe with that white tiger striping. And if you look at South Korea's secondary kit, it matches perfectly. I'm definitely gonna cop one of those tops. And as you know, with COVID-19 being present everywhere, the Tokyo 2020 Summer Olympic Games were pushed to 2021. And I'm pretty sure Nike didn't wanna wait until 2021 to release these shoes, so they just released them now. So on May 15th, 2020, these South Korea Prestos were made available via the Sneakers app. And I don't know of too many retail locations that actually had these in store, but it was pretty limited. Concerning retail, these cost $130 USD. Add your taxes and your VAT just based on where you reside. Looking at the resale market, these aren't fetching prices that are too like exorbitant. These are going for about $150 USD, whether you're looking at StockX, SneakerCon, or the GOAT app. And to be quite honest, even though this shoe was somewhat limited, I don't anticipate like a year from now when the 2021 Olympics happen that this shoe will shoot up that much in price. I will say that the low resale of the shoe is attributed to the weird sizing system that they are employing. They employ like the extra small to an extra large system, to where the extra small is a 5 to a 7 men's, a small 7 to 9 men's, medium 9 to 11, large 11 to 13, extra large 13 to size 15 men's. Now, this sizing system is actually how Prestos were introduced to the world in 2000, but I just find it weird because you have like the acronyms which fit perfectly on me, and I think these were like done up in whole sizes. I would prefer a whole sizing method versus like this wide range of like extra small to extra large. Like, that sizing system is typical of like aqua socks or like those winter moccasins that you get for Christmas that you really don't want. Since we're on sizing, my true to size is a size 8.5. Now, within their spectrum, that falls within a size small in these Prestos. And honestly, they fit too tight. It's hard to get my foot into this hole. If it's narrow on the inside of the shoe, it just does not fit well at all. It's even hard to wear socks with this shoe. And I really do feel sorry for those that normally rock a size 9 true to size and are getting this shoe. This is not gonna fit on you. You definitely wanna go with a size medium if you're rocking a size 9. The sizing of the shoe, the fitment of the shoe, it is just no bueno. It doesn't fit like my acronym Prestos. These are hella comfortable too. Taking a look at the specifics of the shoe, the upper is mainly done in this neoprene mesh material that is done in this white and black tiger striping, again, reflective of that mascot or the emblem for the South Korea football team. That neoprene meshing enables the shoe to be very breathable, very lightweight, and is supposed to provide some elasticity so your foot can fit in pretty fine, but it conforms too much, is actually pretty constricting on this shoe. On the vamp, we have that black Nike swoosh that is embroidered, and then at the toe, we have that TPU plate right here to prevent fraying from toe drag. What makes a shoe a Nike Presto is this five-finger cage design, which is made out of a TPU material and protrudes from the midsole. So on the lateral, you have the red, on the medial, you have the blue. Again, playing into South Korea's national colors. While this cage provides structural support at the bridge of the shoe, forming a part of the lacing system, it also wraps around the heel cup area for stability purposes. And it's cool because right at the heel you have that gradient of color where it changes from red to blue, and then Korea's national flag right here done up in black. Above that is the gold heel tab. Right out of the box, these shoes come pre-laced. We have a black set of laces that are oval in shape and of a nylon build. The shoe is built sock-like in design, therefore we don't have your traditional tongue employed on the shoe, but at the top we have this rubber emblem right here that is sewn in, displaying the Presto logo. In checking out the lining of the shoe, it is done up in this white meshing material in which the diameter of the holes are pretty wide. They are loose gauge, which enables a lot more breathability and again enables the shoe to be a lot more lightweight than a typical running shoe. This is cool, I like the fabric, I just wish it was done up in red or black or blue, something that won't get dirty so easily. In removing the insoles, I appreciate that they did this in black fabric so it won't get dirty as easily, and it is placed on a thin piece of black foam. At the heel areas, on the left you have that Presto logo, and then the sizing label on the right. This is done up in a gold foil. The midsole of this shoe is easily identified by this white EVA foam that runs along the foundation of the shoe. This is Nike's proprietary technology called Phyline. Smack dab on the lateral side of the shoe, you see this Nike swoosh done up in gold, and then you see five dots at the heel of the shoe. Now, back in the past, Nike would employ these five dots to signify that this is like their alpha prototype or their more advanced shoes, and it just stuck with the Presto since then. On the medial side, some of that TPU caging actually runs down into the midsole area to provide some more support in this arch area. Keeping in line with South Korea's flag theming, the outsoles follow suit, where we have blue on the right and red on the left. Now, these particular panels are done up in Duralon technology. Duralon is a blown rubber component to enable flexibility and durability. Now, towards the heel, you'll see this BRS 1000 technology. If you didn't know, BRS stands for Blue Ribbon Sports. That's what Nike was named before they became a household name Nike. So BRS 1000, and these are built of like carbon rubber plates that are actually more firm than the Duralon technology that you see at the front and at the middle of these shoes. We already talked about sizing. Sizing is atrocious on the shoes. This cutout is not big enough to put my foot inside, and once my foot is inside, it just feels too narrow right here, despite this being made of elastic neoprene material. The uppers of the shoe is just super stiff, but when it actually comes to comfortability, when it goes to the midsole, the outsole, that Phylon, the Duralon, the BRS system, this shoe is pretty comfortable. I mean, I ran these acronym Prestos into the ground pretty much. This is like a daily driver shoe. Like you can see, the traction marking is pretty much gone with this Duralon up here. This BRS system is actually pretty intact. That actually looks pretty good. Literally, these shoes are my daily drivers. I love these acronym Prestos. I'm actually looking for another set, and I'm surprised they're not going for too much nowadays. Overall, I really do love the theming of the shoe and how it pays homage to the South Korea flag of the white, the black, the blue, the red. It looks pretty good, and I like how they specified that this shoe is for the South Korea football team, the South Korea soccer team, and how it matches that secondary kit perfectly. It looks good and it plays well with the tiger striping, the tiger mascot. At $130, this shoe is pretty comfortable. You just have to be aware of the sizing system that is employed. Again, I wear an 8.5 true to size. On the charge that falls into a size small, I actually wish I would have went with a size medium on this particular shoe, especially since it's narrow up here. Outside of sizing, I really don't have anything bad to say about the shoe. It's a dope shoe. Maybe we could have used a Filipino flag back here, but it is what it is. Anyways, I think this is a good stopping point for this video. What do you think about the South Korea Prestos, the Red Orbit Prestos? Good pickup, bad pickup? Are you gonna try to cop them on like the resale market? Let me know your thoughts down in the comments below. Go ahead and check out my Instagram, Chris Cataluña with the underscore at the end. Go ahead and like, subscribe, and hit that notification bell so you know when I upload a new video. And guys, we finally hit 10,000 subs on this channel. Thank you for your support. Once we hit 25K, we'll do another raffle, yeah? All right, guys, I'm Chris Cataluña, and we will check you next time. Cheers. See you now.